Nothing like a long, cold winter to have you craving the sun.
But without the right protection, those rays can be deadly. And we've learned that many local schools have policies now that actually make it harder for kids to protect themselves. Here's WLWT News 5's Jackie Conjato with a News 5 investigation.
Mike and Cherie, a few months ago, just before my 27th birthday, doctors found a cancerous mole on my back, and now sunscreen is part of my daily routine. Doctors say we should teach our kids that kind of sun safety when they're young, but we found that in a lot of cases, school policy makes that a real hassle.
Meet Shannon Lake and Julie Barzak, two young women with everything going for them. Shannon, a former Bengal and businesswoman. Julie, a mom of two who married her high school sweetheart. Storybook lives until that dermatologist's visit. And then that phone call.
I immediately looked at my 16-month-old son and just thought, you know, gosh, this is real.
Never, you know, at age 35 would I think that I would, you know, have melanoma or have to deal with this.
35 and 32 years old, skin cancer patients. And it's a diagnosis their doctor, Brett Coldiron, gives all too often. As the president-elect of the American Academy of Dermatology, he has a clear picture of the national epidemic.
The national rate of increase in melanoma and non-melanoma skin cancer is varying between 2 to 5% per year. That means it's going to double every 15 to 20 years. I think that's an epidemic.
On average, studies show skin cancer kills one American every hour.
And it's all from sun exposure. These are all preventable.
The question is, why aren't those experts consider most at risk taking precautions?
My time working with athletes has really discovered that athletes, frankly, don't use sunscreen.
Dr. Brian Adams heads the University of Cincinnati's Department of Dermatology, and he runs a sports dermatology clinic. He's spent years asking athletes like Matt Williams why.
I've never really used sunscreen during baseball. It's not really something that comes to my mind that I need to put on, really.
Williams says his trainers have it available. It's just not part of the culture.
I think it was something that, like, hey, you have to do it for a game. I think players would do it.
My goal is that there's a nice big jug, same sort of jug that's full of sunscreen, so that athletes can apply and reapply.
Access or culture, we found part of the problem may start well before college. Many tri-state K-12 schools have policies that make it harder for kids to protect themselves at recess or during sports.
I would say in high school was, I don't ever really remember having it available in high school.
Local school nursing authorities say each public school district creates their own policy about sunscreen. While administrators may choose to turn a blind eye, in most cases, sunscreen is considered an over-the-counter topical medication, prohibited without a doctor's note. In general, public schools don't encourage kids to bring it, and they don't provide it.
And I think that it's something the schools will catch up with. It's just like wearing any other sort of protective equipment. And you let them out to play, they ought to have some sunscreen on. And I think that's kind of a no-brainer.
A no-brainer that Shannon and Julie are making sure they pass on to their families.
My three-year-old will go outside and remind, Mommy, we need to do sunscreen.
Both wish they could change the past, but vow to make no mistakes about protection in the future.
Just like any helmet in football or whatnot, it's a shield, and it should be a shield provided for every child. I do believe that.
School nursing officials say they do encourage sun safety education. There's even a curriculum available called Sunwise that's often provided to teachers during May. But critics say it's not enough just to teach kids about sunscreen. They argue it should be provided and practiced at school. Jackie Conjato, WLWT News 5.